Hey guys, welcome back.
Holding my breath and I'm ready to go. I'm falling right in and I'm ready to go. I found what I want and I know that we're on top. So I'm tapping and I'm ready to whoa. Holding my breath and I'm ready to go. I catch you laughing and I'm ready to go.
You're hey guys, welcome back and hello if you're new. My name is Sarah and I make lots of lifestyle content, once for dinner videos, plus size fashion, beauty, mommy stuff, and now we're doing some grocery hauls. I don't know why I haven't done grocery hauls in the past. They're one of my favorite videos to watch because I get good ideas of groceries to pick up, and because it's pretty much a free video. I do grocery shopping, why not film it? So I've also gotten a couple requests from you guys to film some grocery hauls and just show you kind of like our meal planning and stuff like that to go along with our what's for dinner videos. So we're gonna start trying to do that. So we do grocery pickup at Walmart. We've been doing it probably for 4 years now, but especially during COVID and stuff, it's just incredibly convenient and easy and safer. And so we, this is all from Walmart grocery pickup. And there's a mixture of groceries and some school supplies because in Texas, school's about to start in less than a month, which is crazy. Because this summer has been the fastest summer of my whole entire life. I cannot believe how fast it has gone by. There's just been so much that's happening, and it's crazy that in less than a month, the girls are gonna go back to school. But we have decided to opt for virtual learning or at-home learning just because of some of the high risks that are around. My mom's high risk. I used to be high risk when I was pregnant, and it's just not worth it to me. So we're gonna do at-home learning. So I do have a bunch of school supplies that we also picked up just to kind of help start that off. And yeah, so I'm gonna also try to make sure I mention the actual meals that I will be cooking with this food, and then you will see them later in a what's for dinner video. So stick around if you haven't subscribed. I would love it if you hit the subscribe button down below and turn on that post notification bell so you're notified every time I post. And if you haven't already, I'd also really appreciate if you followed me on Instagram at Sarah England. And let's get started with the grocery haul. All right, so starting right here, we have Dr. Pepper, Diet Dr. Pepper. My favorite is Dr. Pepper 10, but it's been really hard to get my hand on them during this whole entire thing. I don't know why. I don't know if they're just not having an easy time making it as much or what, but it's my favorite, but I also like Diet Dr. Pepper. We have this Great Value Puff Corn, which is like a knockoff of Pirate's Booty, and this is so freaking good. I've gone through like 7-8 bags. I'm not even kidding, I'm the only one who's eating it. My girls like it too, but it's my like secret snack. And if you watch Amanda from Mom's Messy Kitchen here, she's the one who shared this on a video, and I blame her for my new addiction because it is so freaking good. You need to try it. Next, we have wonton strips. We are having a big like chicken barbecue ranch salad this week for a main like our dinner, and so we have some wonton strips. Please ignore my children for killing one another, but to go on top of it to add a little crunch. My husband wanted some barbecue chips, so he has some of that. I have some organic sage, even though I had thyme put down, but they didn't have it, so they substitute with sage. Not the same thing. So I'm gonna try to get some time hopefully this week. They gave me some fresh salsa. I didn't have this down, but to make sure I didn't pay for it because I didn't have it down, but we will make do with that. We have two baked potatoes and we have an avocado to go with the salad. Baked potatoes are going with the chicken dish that we have coming up this week, which I'll talk about in a second. We have two sweet potatoes because I'm making a sweet potato curry. That sounds amazing and I'm really excited about it. So we have two sweet potatoes to roast, a sweet onion, and a bell pepper. All of these are going in the curry. We have some grape tomatoes to go for the salad. Ollie is obsessed with seaweed, just like I am. So this is on every single grocery pickup, and it's just the ocean tail of sea salt. I wish that I could bulk buy seaweed. So if you know a place that has like bulk buying seaweed, that's easy to get your hands on, that isn't like an Asian market, it's just something easy to get your hands on, let me know, because we love seaweed and we always get it every time we have a grocery pickup. So some seaweed. Like I said, we have a red bell pepper, a zucchini that I'm going to saute. I love zucchini. I'm the only one in this house that does, but I make everyone eat it anyway. watermelon. This is the only fruit we could get our hands on. We had like 4 or 5 other freaking fruits on there, but apparently fruit is also in high demand right now. So I'm so thankful we at least got some watermelon because we have like zero fruit in the house. Cheese. We have sharp cheddar cheese slices, a block of sharp cheddar, and then American cheese slices because We are the cheese people. I don't know. We love cheese. I actually really, really like this cheese. I know it's great value, it's super cheap, but it's actually, it looks like it's all hurt, but this is really good cheese for what you get. We have a huge bag of romaine salad mix for our salad. Some bread. The girls have been into some donuts. So we have Mrs. Baird's Grab and Go powdered sugar donuts. I know, so healthy, but whatever. We have some mozzarella cheese and some smoothies, animal smoothies for the girls, some half and half for a recipe and for my coffee. And then we have some Purdue chicken tenders for the salad that we're doing this week. And then these are my husband's requests, the spicy chicken patties from Tyson. He loves these and he eats them all the time for like lunches or for dinners. If we're just having leftover random dinners, he eats these, as well as these gosh darn things, which are the mac and cheese from Stouffer's. When I was pregnant and I just couldn't cook anything, this is what he ate Monday through Friday. And I swear to you, I wanted to like burn Stouffer's plants down because I never wanted to smell them again. But here we are, back at it. We have some panko breadcrumbs I'm making with a chicken, like a yummy baked roasted chicken thing from Jessica O'Donohue. She had a really good looking recipe, so I got some of that. We have some traditional pasta sauce from Great Value. I use this for pretty much every recipe. I used to use Prego, but I think this is just as good and it's cheaper, and I normally can get my hands on it all the time. I use this for spaghetti or for lasagna or for anything that I need pasta sauce with. I think it's great. We have some sun-dried tomatoes. I'm making a pasta that I saw on here on YouTube from my friend Julia, and so it looked amazing, so I'm making that, and that will be in our What's for Dinner. So we're having like a sun-dried tomato mozzarella pasta. I don't even know what to call it, but it sounded amazing. We have these Velveeta skillets. This is the chicken and broccoli. This is like a really easy, I'm no not healthy meal, but it's something that's really, really easy that my whole entire family likes. I normally just get a rotisserie chicken. We have that with this and then some fruit and call it a day, and it's delicious and really fast. Then we have some little bites. These are Eleanor's very favorite. We have some chicken broth for the curry, as well as some for the pasta, and because we always need chicken broth, some penne noodles for the pasta. Over here, we have some coconut milk for the curry. We have some ranch style beans that I'm gonna use for the salad. I thought that would add some texture and flavor. I love ranch style beans. If you've never tried them, you need to. Reese's artichoke hearts that I'm gonna throw into the, if I don't break it, goodness gracious, I'm gonna put this into the pasta. We always need ketchup because we go through ketchup like water, and ranch dressing because I used to love making it and I just haven't in a while, and you know what, Hidden Valley always comes through. Speaking of Hidden Valley, we also had some ranch seasoning to add to the chicken, and because I literally always have this on hand for just about everything. And then Buffalo Wild Wings makes my all-time favorite barbecue sauce, and they do have it in a pack, which is what I already have. But we're running low on the barbecue sauce, and I didn't want to spend another like $9 for two of the other bottles that aren't barbecue. And I noticed that they sell these individually now, so I was really excited. If you haven't tried this, this is so good. It's my favorite barbecue sauce. I'm incredibly picky with barbecue sauce, and it's sweet and spicy, and it's really, really good. You like it, huh, Jazz?
I love it.
Jazz really likes it too. So, really, really yummy. And that is gonna go for the barbecue chicken salad this week. All right, sliding over here, we have school supplies. So I'll go over here real quickly. We have napkins. These are the Trolls World Tour napkins. I thought this was like the cutest napkin ever. And then some frozen two napkins. The reason I get these are for the girls' lunches. It just makes them fun, and I can kind of like decorate, make them all bento style and really cute and fun. So we still have quite a bit, but I like to add normally every year and plus every season for holidays. You guys have seen, if you watch my kids' lunch videos, you've seen that I do these types of napkins. So I got two packs. I had an LOL one down, but they didn't have it, so we at least have these two packs. And then I also use cupcake liners. I use silicone cupcake liners, as well as actual just like paper or tin cupcake liners to house their food and kind of separate things. Ollie's gotten really picky on her food touching, so these will come in handy, and I thought they would match with the frozen one. We'll make it work. Some cupcake liners, some shampoo, some pencil erasers to add extra pizzazz to the pencils, 2 packs of colored pencils for each kid, some of these number 2 wood pencils because they were rainbow, thought the girls would like them, a pack of fine tip markers, and 2 packs of the regular broad line chubby markers. And then we have 2 packs of the Crayolas crayons, 2 things of Elmer school glue, glue stick packs, and then 2 packs of construction paper. I also have a bunch of other school supplies that I've gotten and stuff that we will be getting, so I will do a whole video just alone on that if you are looking for some ideas and if you are doing at home learning as well. And yeah, so that is the gist of everything. Alright, so that is the end of this video. I hope you guys got some good ideas of some new groceries to try. Definitely check out the Buffalo Wild Wings barbecue sauce as well as those cheese puffs. You will not regret it, friends. Anyway, leave a comment below if you are looking forward to school starting again, or if you can't even imagine the idea and what you guys are doing, if you're sending your kiddos back or if they are staying home with you. Let me know what you guys have decided. In Texas, the rates are astronomical, so we are definitely not sending them back, but I know a lot of people are sending their kiddos, so I would love to know what you guys are doing. Anyway, that is it for this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys soon in my next video. Bye guys.